Do you know what this is?
Do you know what it is?
How much is it now? $2?
Hi, good afternoon. What's your take on Dogecoin?
It's Bentley.
Hey, it's Joe from Cointelegraph here at the WEF. Behind me. And Bitcoin and blockchain and crypto all in front of me. We're going to do some conversations with people on the street. Hello, do you know what Bitcoin is? You do? Would you like to talk to about it on camera? We're here with Cointelegraph.
No, I don't know enough about it to talk about it.
That's part of the process. We can learn about it together.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine. When you're not really fine, you just have to say that you're fine.
Hi, good afternoon. Hey. Hi, good afternoon. Do you know what this is?
Do you want to talk about it? No?
Hi, good afternoon. Curious. Here we go. Hi, good afternoon.
Hi.
Do you know what this is?
It's a what?
Coin. Some coin. Okay, some coin.
He needs some milk.
Hey.
I think it's not Bugatti, it's Bentley.
Bentley.
Hey, do you know what this is?
Coin? Do you know what it is?
How much is it now? $2?
Some zeros.
I lost so much money.
So what is Bitcoin for you? What does it mean for you personally?
It's a financial freedom. It's a personal freedom.
It's freedom, and it's the catalyst for decentralization, the first proof for humans.
Not sure about how good it is for the environment because of the carbon emissions.
The future of finance.
Wow, okay, that was
yes.
Great.
Nice. Decentralization.
I love them.
Oh, nice. Why do you love them?
Well, I think that a lot of the traditional financial institutions that have existed on Earth have existed in an environment without clear competitors. Right? And you know, maybe this is a strange view of mine, but I think that when we create environments and financial systems where there's innovation allowed and where competitors can thrive against old ideas, it ultimately benefits everyone around the world. And we're actually facing a time right now where people's access to financial institutions is more important than ever. Because what that means is that is people from the global south that don't necessarily have access to traditional financial resources like traditional banks that we have in America. So I love Bitcoin, I love all the associated cryptocurrencies because it's innovation, and sometimes it doesn't go well, but that's the thing about companies and innovations, you gotta flop to win.
Bitcoin is high, you know how I feel. When Bitcoin is low, you know how we feel. Dogecoin in the sky, we know how we feel. It's a new high, it's a new low, it's a new dawn, and I'm feeling good.
There's a lot of curiosity about the whole cryptocurrency, bitcoins and other cryptocurrencies as well. But it also seems a little risky. Our government is not in favor, but there are people who are very curious and learning more about it.
Bitcoin is transforming Africa.
Okay.
I'm originally Nigerian, and I see how the introduction of electronic money, Bitcoin, is transforming the economy. That right now, trade is taking off without people having to resolve to classical money channels.
Okay.
And I think it's got a bigger role to play in the future as long as the whole problems are taken care of, right?
Well, I think crypto environment in Lisbon is like lots more accessible. You know, you go to like really very old cafe. and you just stay there and you can meet all the crypto people. It's very easy.
My family ran away from a country that took every single thing from them. So when they ran away, they couldn't take anything with them, right? Yeah. Soviet Union collapsed. They were left absolutely penniless. So did millions and millions of other people. And we have so many injustices happening in the world right now. Over 50 armed conflicts happening right now. I live in the Middle East, and there are a lot of governments out there who feel it's their business to meddle in the Middle East. So there's so many people in Palestine who don't have many things to run away with, and if they could have some of that, can you imagine, you know, how their families would be better off? Yeah. And that's what we see. This is it's all great for you and I. We live in the Western world. We have bank accounts. We have credit cards. We are, you know, we are that tiny percentage that participate in financial markets. We have that financial freedom, but there's so many people living under oppressive governments and living in countries that are being bombed right now, so they need this more than you and I do.
The role of money is to guarantee your purchasing power. The problem with fiat and the inflation system is that it has pushed everybody to become an investor and become bad at your job, because you now have to fight inflation constantly. You have to invest in bonds or invest in X or Y. Money doesn't exist anymore. And so what we need now is essentially, go back to a non-inflation system, a system where you know that your kids will be able to benefit from the fruit of your labor, because you consider that their marginal propension to spend is more valuable than yours, because you're very happy.
You do not have to have a government to tell you what to do. I mean, you have...
Do not comply.
Yeah, hello. I mean, I'm sure you have some gray matter between your ears, so does everybody else. So why do you have to have a government to tell you that Bitcoin is now a legal tender? You and I can trade right now. Bitcoin is being used as a medium of exchange in hundreds and hundreds of countries. I mean, look at countries in Eastern Europe. I mean, Russia, more than 25% of Russians transact in Bitcoin and using it as a medium of exchange, because there's really, really good people out there, and they absolutely had nothing to do with the government is doing. And there are really, really bad people on the other side of the fence, and they're transacting Bitcoin, they're transacting cryptocurrencies as well. So it's always a double sword age. Yes, thank you very much. It's been day number four.
It's not just speculation, but actually it means, you know, to have blockchain technology coming into every vertical of economic sector, right? So, and I think that was my biggest thing, is like, you know, never ignore something for someone, right? So, and that's why it's like, you know, if you already in crypto, it's great. If not, you know, don't ignore it. One day you'll wish you would. Right?
Younger generation is a lot more curious about what Bitcoin and cryptocurrency is all about. And of course, some bit of rethinking and action needs to happen on making it sustainable. But yeah, I mean, it's all about awareness and education.
We're going to wrap it up here. But as you can see, the environment towards Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies at the World Economic Forum in Davos 2022 is differing. Some people know what a Bitcoin is. Some people don't even want to say the word Bitcoin. This has been Cointelegraph 2022.